Hello, welcome to the Blessing Report. In this video, we are talking about why Christian men do not pursue women of God. I'm gonna get right into it. I'm gonna tell the truth, then we're gonna have a good time. So hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, turn on your bell notifications. If you're new here, I'm Winston Mayo. This is the Blessing Report, and let's get to the show. Hey, welcome to the Blessing Report, the channel for comedy and conviction, entertainment, edification. I'm Winston Mayo, the regular Christian guy, and we have a great video today, and it is called Why Christian Men Do Not Pursue Women of God. And it was actually sparked, I was going to talk about this for a while, but it was sparked by Ezekiel Azunwu. He's a spoken word poet out of California, and the PIA tour, Jackie Hill Perry, Preston Perry, Joseph Solomon, and he put up basically a poll on his Instagram about like single Christians and Christian dating and the struggle, and he did it from the male perspective and the female perspective. So he has 6 points that he wants to make. So top reasons it's a struggle for Christian ladies to find a Christian man. So number one, good Christian men are too rare. Number two, Christian men don't want real purity. Number three, Christian bachelors won't commit. Number four, I'm too damaged to date. Number five, Christian men don't approach me. And number six, they don't meet my standards. So I'm going to give y'all the top reason that I see that Christian men do not pursue women of God. And I'm just going to go down the list and what I see in life. So from the female perspective, so not the guy perspective, why it's like hard for you to find a man of God. My number one reason is Christian men are not men of God. So I just want to make like the distinction. A lot of people are very satisfied with a very low standard of what is considered a man of God. I do not consider someone who just goes to church a man of God, but a lot of people are culturally Christian, especially if you're in the Western United States or have an American Christianity. And so I think that this goes into the second one, which is Christian men don't really want purity. So this is why I would say a man of God is different from just like a Christian man or a church boy or something like that, a cultural Christian, because men of God are honoring God at all times. And if you are able to like challenge a woman in purity or tempt her, right? It says like the love of the world, if that is in you, the love of the Father is not in you. It says that whoever is like the bringer of temptation, woe to them. It is better if they were never born, and if a stone was tied to their neck, and that they were dragged to the bottom of the sea. So if we're just talking about a baseline of like, yo, in Christian dating, if someone's not respecting your purity, that sounds like sinfulness to me. Like, for you to actively, this is like sin. Sin separates you from God, and sin sends you to hell. So for a man to be willing to engage in sexual intercourse or sexual, any type of activity and not respect purity, and he's not living out purity himself, number one, he does not have reverence for God. You are not honoring him. You do not care about him. You do not love God to actively be okay with sin in your own life. So you are okay with dragging this woman into your sin and be a partner with that. But two, you do not have a fear of the Lord, right? That he is able to not only destroy your body, but to destroy the soul and cast it into hell. So that's why I would really not consider any guy that is actively living a lifestyle of sin to be considered a man of God. He can be a cultural Christian, because that term is used really loosely. He can be a church boy. Oh, I always grew up in church. My dad's a pastor. I do not care. If your life and your heart does not reflect God, then, yo, that's about it, right? So that is like the number one like perspective when it comes to the female perspective. But if we're talking about like from the man perspective, like the struggles that we are facing, I think the number one is the same for both. Men are finding that women are not really women of God, and that there's like this casual cultural Christianity where women are okay being both in the world and both in the church. So what we are finding that there is not a death when it comes to the world. It's not a death to self. It's not a death to a lifestyle, but it's a double dipping, right? And so with that, we are struggling, and this is on Ezekiel's like man list too, right? That we are finding that like Christian women aren't as Christian as they are, say they are or believe them to be, because we aren't even talking about like deep stuff. We can't get Christian women to undertake basic Christian principles, right? And then when we bring it up, they're like, oh, be more patient, be more gracious. But what you're really saying is be more tolerant of carnality, worldliness, and sin, right? So if women, a guy, y'all are like, oh my gosh, he won't respect my purity. And on the men's side, we're like, dang, bro, she really don't love God like that. It's like, it's a give and take, right? So women of God, women of God and men of God, we're finding that we can find a Christian that's okay doing like cute stuff, right? Like Bible study, going to church, praying. But holiness, sanctification, Christ-likeness, looking like him, being distinct and set apart from the world, that's the struggles of people who are living this out and people who only honor God with their words and not with their life, all right? And so, crap, are you serious? And so that is like my like number one for women, number two, one for men, just sinfulness, worldliness, carnality with that, all right? But I think another reason women like struggle with finding a man of God is like two things, right? Ezekiel is like number one. This is not in an order or anything. He said, good Christian men are too rare. And then Christian bachelors won't commit. So I'm just going to give y'all like some hard numbers, right? The church, we're talking about the corporate church on the earth, is primarily female. That is 80 to 90% female. So even if we are giving like good numbers to the men, at most what you're going to find is that 20% of the church is male, like dateable. We're not even talking about y'all are attracted to each other. We're not even talking about demographic age range. We're not even talking about holiness. We're just talking about, yo, there's some men in the church. And so with that, what I find in myself is that Christian men have way too many options because the church is 90 to 80% female. So for every one dude there's four women that we can pick from. And so when the list says Christian men won't commit, I do think that is carnality, lustfulness, right? A gluttony. It's like a gluttony of women. Like you have all these options. And so I am able, because like just simple like supply and demand principles, I'm able to wait out. I don't have to pursue a woman because I have like my pick. If like you are not okay with like holiness, I can find a woman of like fineness, like legit, that is okay with this. And so we are able to be more like picky or whatever. But usually men, what you're seeing like in the church, we're not talking about men of God, people living it out, is that men will be like, Christian women are not as attractive as worldly women. Christian women aren't as sexy. But what they're really saying, you got the legit read between the lines. What they're saying is that Christian women are holy. Christian women have standards. Christian women are set apart. And Christian women are not carnal and they're not sinful. Because it's just like racism. Racism is dumb because you can't be like, I am not attracted to white women. I'm not attracted to black women. I'm not attracted to Asian women. So you are telling me that the ugliest black woman is more attractive than the most attractive Asian woman, the most attractive white woman? No, that's dumb. So how can you say like, oh, the most attractive Christian woman is not as attractive as like the ugliest worldly woman? So what they're saying is that, well, Christian women are not attractive. They're saying Christian women are not sinful. Christian women are not carnal. Christian women are not worldly. And the lustful appetite in me is not satisfied with them. And so you just have to distinguish standard, all right? So this is why Christian men don't commit, because they have two main options. They are talking to two main Christian women. And we're talking about especially with the implementation of social media. Social media is allowing a lot of people to move ungodly, to move carnally, to move like really wickedly actually, to be like juggling women, because you can be as passive as you want, all right? So that's one, but I do want to make a distinction between sinfulness and spiritual maturity. So you can find someone that is like, I'd rather take any day of the week a man who is pursuing God for real, that is spiritually immature, because that just means it's early, than a man who is sinful, right? Because what they have is just like for real, it is lust, right? You just have such an appetite that's what sin is. It is sensational. Like, you cannot be satisfied with money, you cannot be satisfied with success, you cannot be satisfied with women, because sin is never satisfied. And so when it comes to passiveness, so that's another one. Christian men do not approach me. I would not put that into sinfulness. I will put that into like spiritual maturity. And this is why I said, a man that is like a man of God, you are walking in your purpose. Number one, 2 Timothy 1:7, God has not given you the spirit of fear, but power, love, and a sound mind, all right? So a lot of guys, they have problems approaching women, not because of sinfulness, but out of fear and spiritual immaturity. Because what we find is that like some women are like really spiritually mature, and so that is intimidating to a man who is not secure in himself. I am not insecure in an area where I am stable, but it's like sports. Like, yo, you know you're the best, you're the best. No one can really challenge you on it. But when it comes to spiritual maturity and spiritual discipline, knowledge of the Bible, ability to pray, men who are insecure about that or are lacking in that area are intimidated when they are faced. But the second one was that we would take on like a submissive role with women when we're called to be the head and so called to be the covering over women. And so with that, I think there is a level of protection and a level of wisdom if a man is unable to be confident in himself that he can approach you, right? So this is I guess another point. It is hard to gauge Christian women, like legit, because of women do not want to be the pursuers. They want to be pursued. But I really think they're taking that Bible verse out of context, right? It says, he who finds a wife finds a good thing. But it is not fine as in search and seeking as if something is hidden. It is fine as in to obtain. Same context when we talk about favor, right? And that's the second part. He who finds a wife finds a good thing and obtain and finds favor with the Lord, right? And so if we're using fine as he obtains favor with the Lord, it's weird that we are using find in the first half of the context to mean to search, right? He who finds a wife gotta like search her out. But when we talk about favor, is fine as in obtain. And so it's hard to gauge Christian women because they be like, I don't want to be a pursuer. I need to be found. You are not putting yourself in position to be found, right? So you're not engaged. And I don't mean like, yo, you gotta flirt, you gotta pursue, or nothing like that. But like, when women, what we find is, what I find in the church and my friends find in the church is that when women of God a dude, she don't talk to him at all. Like, and it's real hard. Like, you feeling a girl and then it's like, yo, I need to find a way to talk to her. It's a lot of responsibility on the dude. It's a lot of responsibility isn't bad, but it's like hindrance. Like, you are making it like harder than work. It's like, oh, I like him, I'm gonna act like I don't like him. That's weird. And that's just mature. Like, we're adults now. We are full grown adults. Like, we're trying to get married. We're trying to have families and have kids. So that's weird. And so with that, we have to have some type of maturity on both sides. So if Christian men aren't pursuing you, it's okay. That's like, I feel like that's a really good filtering system of like confidence, because what Christian women are saying is like, Black Hebrew Israelites, they pursuing me. Worldly dudes, they pursuing me. Muslim men, they're pursuing me. But what you're finding is that they have confidence. And so if a Christian man isn't confident enough to at least break the ice of introductions, then I think that's a hedge of protection. I think that is God's provision of like, yo, why do you want a dude that isn't confident and bold? Like, if you are given the gospel in your everyday life, you are talking to people. So I think there's a lack. Like, right, I can't talk to a regular woman about pursuit. How can I talk to anybody about the gospel of Jesus Christ? So y'all just need to see like the parallels in this. And so be okay with that. But at least be okay with not initiating interest, but engaging in interest. Like, if a dude does not feel like you are interested in him, or he doesn't think it can elevate from friends, he's not going to. More often than light. Like, real confident dudes, real bold dudes, they're going to go after what they want. But spiritual maturity, I'm okay with a dude who just need like, just a little hint that you might be interested. You don't gotta flirt you. And that's the thing. Introductions, engagement, talking, that is not pursuit, right? You are not pursuing a man just being like, hey, my name is Ashley or something like that. So just acknowledge, like, be in a atmosphere that you can be found, right? So stop trying to believe that you're just gonna find a Christian man at home. I'm not saying go to the club, because again, that's sinful. I'm not saying going to the club is sinful, but that atmosphere is sinful. You're gonna attract sinfulness more than a Christian man. So like, go out. Like, there are a lot of Christian concerts. There's a lot of Christian rap concerts. There's a lot of Christian parties. There's a lot of Christian comedy shows. Like, atmospheres where you can be found. And so like, set it up for yourself, right? Set up opportunities for you to be found. I think I actually covered most of them. The last two are Christian men don't meet my standards. And we're gonna keep it 100 on both sides, right? Basically what you're saying is that Christian men are ugly, unattractive, or something like that. Something vain. So we have to really distinguish where that root is coming from, if your standards are godly or if your standards are coming from the world. Because a lot of people will like to tell women, your standards are too high. No. What they're saying is that you're holy, you're righteous, you live by the Bible. That's Christian basics 101. That's not even something that's up for discussion. That should be in the not on the table. Like, of course we're not having sex. Of course we're not, I don't know what else like worldly fake Christian men want to do, but we're not doing that. That's Christian basics number one. But standards like are, it's like a list, right? List is not godliness. We're just talking about, oh, if he's under 5'7", we can't date. Eh. If he doesn't have a beard, we can't date. Eh. If he, I don't even know. He got to have this much money. Where is that coming from, right? Because with those filters, you will filter out Jesus. Like, Jesus does not fit some of these standards. And what we're finding is that women don't have grace. We'll say both men and women don't have grace for things that are not on their list. So men's side probably like very carnal. Both of these are carnal, like big breasts, big butt, like something really dumb, something very carnal. And so I'm not saying attraction is not important, but we have to distinguish vanity from attraction. Because a lot of this stuff is really surface level. And if you go to Proverbs 31, I think it's 30, it says, beauty is fleeting, charm is vain, but a woman of God will praise the Lord and be honored or like respected or something like that. And so we really need to say like what's internal. And so I'm not saying like lower your standards with anything. If you want to be picky, but don't complain that you're picky and single, all right? And so the same thing with these men. I mean, women is like, oh, these men aren't approaching me, but like legit, being saved and single is not, it does not make a marriage. It does not make a relationship. People always trying to put me together would be like, oh, why don't you date Samantha? I don't think I know a Samantha in real life. why don't you date Samantha? Y'all both single and Christian. I'm not attracted to Samantha. But I'm okay being single. A lot of people are, they want to be married and stuff like that. They are discontent in their singleness, which is another problem, because that's just an indication of connection to God. Like, just because you're single doesn't mean that you're alone. And so with this, you have to understand that there's a difference with that. So if you have a high standard, be okay with your high standard, but also be okay with how much you are limiting your pool. You have 20% of the church, he needs a beard. You have 10% of the church, he needs to be tall. You have 5% of the church, he needs to have a lot, I don't know, whatever you want, just know you are limiting your pool. So don't complain about it. And so when you're limiting your pool, you might sacrifice godliness for a beard, which is dumb. You might sacrifice holiness for height, and that's dumb. So just know what you are exchanging things for. But you can't find it. You can definitely find all of it, but be okay waiting for that. But I do want to like really let that resonate with like many women here, that I'll like suggest one of my Christian dudes and then you'll just write him off and just be like, nah, he's just a friend, I'm not really interested. That's cool. But I'm really advocating for men who are men of God, right? And so if y'all know the comedian Kev on Stage, he's like, yo, I don't need to be attractive to every woman. I just need to be attractive to one woman. And so he says like his wife, he's out of his league, but he's a man of God, he's funny. So really distinguish like what type of godly things that you are sacrificing. Like, he's funny and that's how he has like a more attractive wife. So if you are like, man, it's hard finding a dude, what qualities are you neglecting? Are you neglecting like ability to pray, ability to cover you, to lead you, to wash you in the word? Because Ephesians 5 says that is what a man of God is supposed to do. But you want something else. You want something that reflects the world. Like a lot of this on the man side, you want something carnal and from the world. On the woman side, with the men, you want something carnal and from the world. And so really ask the Lord, like, is your list holy? Is your list righteous? Is your list godly and God-honoring? Because a lot of women and men, what you're finding is that you do not want a man of God. You want God himself. And we can't meet those standards. And so the last one that Ezekiel has on his list is that it's hard to find a man of God because I'm too damaged. And so I really want to be honest about this. It is really hard as a single man, like dating or pursuing because of the past. Because like the Lord says, the past is passed away. There is no condemnation in Jesus Christ. We are a new creation. But a lot of women at really, we need to talk about single motherness in the church. Talking about like a lot of the women that we are trying to pursue, they don't have an active, healthy father in their lives as like an example. So maybe absent from the home, but some of them, their dads are present in the home but absent from their life, like actively engaging or actively a man of God. And so what we're finding is that that damage is happening to them, but also just like worldly dudes like doing them dirty. And so when we're trying to engage or trying to pursue, trying to like live it out, there is a level of like brokenness on both sides, because men are broken as well. But spiritual health, spiritual wellness, spiritual wholeness that is absent. So you're not trying to build a relationship on the guy side. We're actually trying to build a person. And that's really hard. Nobody can build a person but God, the Holy Spirit, and Jesus, and his blood, and his redemption. So we can really encourage, we can teach, but we're not really supposed to be salvation for people. And so if you are dealing with like condemnation, guilt, or shame, know that doesn't come from God. Because there is no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. Romans 8, I'm pretty sure. Might be wrong, but the verse is in the New Testament. And so I really think that is an attack from the enemy. I'm too damaged. Was Moses too damaged? Was David too damaged? Was any of these other flawed people too damaged? So for real, that's just an illusion. So a lot of, I keep saying a lot for most of these. I'm speaking in generalizations. But we do find is that Christian women would be like, dang, like this dude's like really godly. I'm not worthy of him. And that's like, that's a terrible mindset. Like, who is not worthy? We're not worthy of God. Like, legit, if we keep it at 100, but he still loves us. So give yourself grace enough to know that if this man of God, like legit, a real man of God, not a fake one, is supposed to be like a reflection of God, then his love isn't conditional, isn't vain. It's that true agape love that the Lord reflects himself. So if you don't believe like a man of God can love you, really the extension might be like the root might be you don't believe that God himself can love you. All right, so I was like, listen, a lot of things of like, oh, why Christian dating is hard. I think it's 1 Timothy. It says, contentment and godliness is great gain. So I guess like advice, if you really do want to get married, do not require something that you are not yourself. All right. So if you want a godly dude, be godly yourself. Both sides, men of God think, Christian, just regular Christian women, church women are not godly. Women of God think that regular men, church guys are not godly. So I do think your standard of godliness, not your just your list, but your standard of godliness is a great filter. So purity, if you don't want dudes to cuss, I don't know actually what a woman's list is on when it comes to godliness, because I think just not having sex is a pretty whack list. There should be some other stuff, like maybe evangelism or spiritual gifting, I don't know. But I think that's a good filter system of like who's whack and like who can actually live this out. And so where in the New Testament it says contentment and godliness is great gain, Song of Solomon's 8:4, it says women and God basically don't awaken love before it's time. And so for you to be so anxious, it says in Philippians, don't be anxious for anything but prayer, supplication, and thanksgiving, being thankful. Make your petitions known to God. And so, like, pray about these things. You want a man of God? Pray about it. Don't let it be an idol. I think that's really, that the church is selling discontentment. And so, you're not a lesser person because you're single. And so, if you are really in your purpose, you are pursuing God, but also, like, doing what you're supposed to be doing as, I don't know, like a pastor, a prophet, an evangelist, a teacher, or an apostle, like something. If you are doing what you're supposed to be doing, then you are more likely to be found than if you are trying to be found and, I don't know, you're just attaching yourself to a man's purpose or whatever. And so don't shrink. I think that's like, all right, so number one, be what you're trying to obtain. Number two, don't shrink at all. A true man of God will embrace your godliness and not try to stifle it. Number three, show interest. I don't know, give a compliment. A compliment will go really well, like legit, just to break the ice. So be like, oh man, you look really nice in your outfit today. You look handsome. I bet a lot of you would really get a man like just by throwing out compliments, but be intentional about it. Don't be playing the field. Women of God play the field, not women of God. Church women play the field just as men as carnal. Church guys play the field. So with that, get out. Like I definitely think like you should get out. Get to like some Christian events. Make conversation. Have referrals. I think referrals are really good. Measure a man of God by a man of God. Be like, yo, like if you need a man of God, be like, yo, Winston, I got this dude. What do you think? And so discernment and just like basic manness, I can see how men move. I can see like how they talk, how they look at women, if they lustful, like stuff like that. Or if they're just like spiritually immature and not ready for you. And so if they don't, like, I wouldn't recommend them. I'm like, yo, I don't even think he's saved. I think he needs to be ministered to. His salvation is more important than a relationship. Then that's the overarching thing. So referrals. Be friendly, again, engage, don't be vain, six, don't be carnal with your list, you know, people aren't obligated your time, like, you don't have to go out and be like, oh, I need to be dating to be found, nope, that's dumb, because you're just gonna waste time and money and, emotional investment, but, you can, I just need like friendliness and interest. You don't gotta flirt, you don't have to be out, you don't have to be in these streets or whatever, but definitely do not, if you wanna be a friend, cool, but if you wanna be more than friend, engage in more than friend behavior, like, I don't know, some type of interest. Call him handsome. I don't know. But you do have to distinguish yourself that he is able to pursue, right? And I don't think I have any more advice for Christian women finding a man of God. So this is why Christian men, church guys, do not pursue women of God, because they're not men of God. But men of God do pursue men of God. And if you see it, and that's another thing, the more I saw godly women existing and really being bold and actually living it out, the more I was content, because that's what the devil wants to do. He really wants you to feel like you have no options, guys aren't really living it out, you're all alone. And because you're discouraged, you lower your standard and then you settle. But if you see more men of God, not like you're interested, just platonic, like dang, they are pure, they are reading their Bible, they do evangelize, they are fine, like it's cool, they are attractive, then your standard will be set. You'll be like, yo, I know at least five dudes right now that are living it out, holy, single, and fine. And so you're not gonna settle for like a Muslim dude or an atheist dude or something like that. Yeah. So let me hear from you. That's my time. It's been my time. But let me hear from you. What has been your experience with like Christian dating and Ezekiel's list? Christian men are too rare. They don't want purity. Bachelors won't commit. I'm too damaged. Christian men don't approach me. They don't meet my standards. So what have you experienced in the comments below? Tell your story. We can engage. And share the video. I really think this, like the tips, especially at the end, will really help a lot of women, I guess, find their like men of God, especially the portion about like being in your purpose. So hit that like button, hit that subscribe button. Remember the schedule, new music Mondays at 7, Winston Wisdom Wednesday, something like that, on Wednesday, 7 p.m., and then Funny Fridays, like comedy videos. And hit us up on all social media platforms. So that's Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, all that. And share this video and support. And remember, everything is in the description box below. The music I play, all the Bible verses, how you can reach me. And remember that this video has been brought to you by my book, Searching for Land. Then my newest book, The Science of Salvation, The Manual for Manufacturing and Manipulating Faith. So that's on Amazon, all your book buying, purchasing areas. So click the link below. And I just want to thank you for watching the video. I know it was long. I was really trying to make my time, but I really wanted to be really thorough about the best tips for really sober and really godly Christian dating and pursuit of marriage and just contentment and singleness. So remember that God blesses people by using people to bless people. So how have you been a blessing today? Thanks for watching.